can I make a sense? How can I put this into word? How can I explain how coming to Ofcentre has affected my life? When I can say, best way to say it is like I never had a life before.
I can remember very clearly my first ever session. Like, I remember sitting down for an hour, and then once I sat up, it was like all this weight was just lifted from me.
Ofcentre is an organisation that supports young people who live in Hackney by offering therapy, counselling and psychosocial activities. Young people come to Ofcentre with an enormous variety of different issues, which range from things like anxiety and depression to questioning identity, disclosing trauma and abuse. There really is a huge kind of range, and I think we try to treat each person as an individual, so there isn't a hierarchy of what's more important. It's really how the issue is impacting on somebody at the time.
You just end up living just to survive. I remember it was more of a numb feeling, and everything was quite, I was always zoned out, a bit blurry, so though you see the long pavement ahead of you and the people moving around you, you're not really attached to any of it, so it's like a bit of a cloud. You just are going through the motions just to get to that desk and book an appointment before I cowered away and ran away. And so I zoned out and just kept following the instructions, step one step in front of the other, buzzing, and step by step, say, this is what I need, and then run away.
You're fighting a war that nobody even realises you're fighting, you know? And you're waging it constantly, and you're giving it your all just to stand in the same place, and if you just stop your resistance for even the slightest bit, you'll just be pushed back in that war. It is an ongoing, continuous, constant battle, 24/7, day and night. Yeah.
That I think it must be a common thing that people feel like there's this huge battlefield within you, and you're fighting, you're continuously fighting something.
I just got so tired and got so depressed, and you know, things in my last year of university just got worse and worse, and I didn't realise this until before I started counselling, but it's like a weight you just carry around with you on your shoulders.
When I came to Ofcentre, I chose to do drama therapy because it was a form of physical release, and it meant that I could express myself in different ways. I like that it uses all the senses and has a way of working with the mind and body.
No one likes suffering in silence. We all want our pain to be perceived by someone, I guess. And that whole judgment thing, it does go into a bit. I mean, it feels like everyone judges you to some point, you know. In the first second of meeting someone, you judge them, but people never judge you as harshly as you judge yourself. So the whole idea of it is coming here and meeting someone who can realign your perceptions, you know.
She hears the true me that's within and gives me a voice and makes it safe for that person to speak.
Art therapy, in a sense, is a subject, I guess, very dear to me because I love art and I love to express myself through painting and drawing and sculpting, anything to do with art. And I think, although growing up it was never valued, art for me was always one of the ways that I expressed the talents and everything that I felt, every emotion that I ever felt, always came out in my artwork, but it was never valued, and so over the years I lost the passion. But art therapy was a good combination of me being able to express how I felt on paper so other people could see, just in case, in a sense, I couldn't fully express through words, but then also the therapy part, that I had a space to talk about my issues and how I was feeling, which I didn't have growing up and I didn't have in my household. And yeah,
I think I put down art therapy or counselling, but I'm glad I did art therapy. But I think I've always felt quite creative, so I thought it'd be a good avenue to go down. But talking was really helpful for me, and doing something at the same time and creating something, it helped me concentrate and sort of not think too much about what I was saying, and helped me sort of talk and. Yeah.
Well, there was that point where I just thought, you know, this isn't going to get better. I might as well just talk to someone, you know. Consequences be damned. But it was scary getting in the door. I mean, people, you talk to people about counselling, they tend to look down on you in a way, you know. For some people, anyway. They see it as weakness on your part. Especially in Asian communities, you know. So you've got that whole stiff upper lip thing that you have to do to it. But yeah, I just got to a point where I thought, might as well try it, you know?
The term mental health that you just used, I think in other services that offered help for people with mental health literally made you feel like you was mentally impaired or mentally crazy, that there was something wrong with you. It wasn't mental health, it's so wide and there's so many forms and it can mean so many things, but with other services I was made out like I was just crazy and I needed help and I needed pills and I needed everything but what I needed, which was just to talk and somebody to listen to me. And Off Centre and art therapy and my therapist gave me the opportunity to be myself and not have to alter how I felt and alter what I was thinking, because I would automatically be made out to be crazy. I can't explain, but for once I didn't feel like I was crazy and I felt like I had issues and I had problems that I needed to discuss, and I didn't need pills and I didn't need to be sanctioned and I didn't need anybody to watch me. I just needed somebody to listen. And I think that's what this service offered me that others didn't.
It was kind of hard to make a review because you can't put to words someone handing you back your life. You can't put that into words. You can't start saying, when you're trying to think, how can I make a sense? How can I put this into words? How can I explain how coming to Off Centre has affected my life? When I can say, best way to say is like, I never had a life before.
Thank you.